Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Apple series. My name is Carl Pullein and this week we're looking at the notifications bar and spotlight on Mac OS. Now these are some of those little unused features that a lot of people have not discovered yet and can actually really give your productivity a major boost, particularly if you're using the notification slide bar from the right hand side of your screen. That is such a useful tool and you can set this up however way you want it. It's actually quite remarkably customizable, and so is Spotlight if you know how to set it up. Now before we go any further, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you would like to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on anything to do with Apple productivity, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me now take you in to my Apple Mac OS Catalina and show you how to get the most out of Spotlight and notifications. Okay, let us start off with how I use the Spotlight search. Now, unfortunately, because they're living in South Korea, we don't have the same full services that you have in Europe, the US, Australia, New Zealand, and other countries. Fortunately, in South Korea, we're pretty limited. So, for example, if I type in weather in Seoul, I actually you can get the weather. So if, for example, if I'm really in a bit of a rush and I think, oh well, is it going to rain today? Now this is a question I often ask myself. Now the weather in Seoul, I can just type this in and it's just going to give me the weather. That's one of the first things that I use it for. But the other thing I use it for mostly, I have to be honest, is I use this as my app launcher. So for example, I can type in reminders and I don't actually have to write the full one. Hit return and it will open up reminders for me just like that. So it's something I always use quite often. I've got so used to this, by the way, and I can just hit this and I can type in calendar and it will open up. I can open up my calendar just like this and bang, it opens up the calendar. So this is one of those features that a lot of people forget to use, but it is so powerful. I mean, I can actually use it to, so for example, this is my demo account, so I don't actually know what I've got on this computer anymore. But if I type in WOD, now WOD relates to a file that I send to my students. And I have an automator, for example, here, which I often send, which I use, is a script that I use with my email to send out the word of the day file. Now, the word of a day file is basically just 7 words that I send out every week to my students. So I can tap on this here, and it's going to bring up like a picture of it in here. And I can just check it. Is this the right one? Blah, 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 blah. Yes, it's the right one. And I can double tap it, and it will open up the sheet. So this is one of the other things I can do. Another one that I've got here, which would be I could write in FT. Now FT can mean FaceTime, but it also can mean the free talking, because the way I name my files, I have a file naming convention, which means that this FT here means that it is my free talking document. I tap on this and it will show me the free talking document that I'm using with my students. So I can tap on any of these and say, is this the right one? Yeah, this is the right one. And so these are some of the useful ways that you can use Spotlight. Now, essentially, I'm using it to find documents, but I also use it to find folders as well. Now, for those of you who are not aware of this, if you go into your settings, what you can do is you can actually go into Spotlight here and you can then choose what you want to use. So you can have the calendar, the calculator, your contacts and stuff like this. So you can actually just type in the name of a person, for example, and it'll come bring all the details up of that person. So again, if I just do command, it's usually command spacebar. It depends on what you're using, because you can set this up. But if I hit this and I can type in my name, Carl Pullein, and it's going to bring up my details, which are here. So I've got my details right here, and you can do this for anybody. Now, as I say, this is my demo account, so it's not actually going to show you very much, but that's just another one. So you can have conversion, which is another cool one, by the way, because when I'm working with my clients, we often talk about the weather. So I can type in, say, today at the moment it is 27 degrees So if I type in 27 degrees, and it's actually going to give me the temperature in Fahrenheit, just that fast. And another way that I use this all the time. And again, you can do simple mathematics. So I can do we can go back to the beginning here. So 2000 times 15, and it will bring up, you know, the actual number for you. So it's another quick access calculator. It's so powerful, and a lot of people are not using it. Now, the second thing that I use a lot is the sidebar notification window. All you do is you use two finger swipe across from the right, and it brings up this function here. Now, you can turn on do not disturb, which I've done because I'm doing recording. Gives me the summary of the day here. So it gives me the weather summary. Again, it's quick access for that. And also it tells me what I have on my calendar. Now, I like to have the world clock up here because I'm dealing with people in different time zones. So Cupertino tell me, because it's just a standard that just tells me what it's like on the west coast of the US. I've got the east coast of US, and I've got London. So I'm covering basically Europe and the US, both sides of the US. So I know in between that are the times that I could be working with my clients. And then I have my calendar here. Now, at the moment, this is not in my regular computer. This is not here. These are just some of the things that I've added for demonstration purposes, like when I have Google Calendar integration. I got my coaching calls, and you can have reminders down here, and you can show more. So when you show all the tasks that are coming up today, so that's all in there, and I can show less or show more. Again, you've got the weather, and again, I like to have the calculator in here, but you can also add a few other things. Now, depending on the apps that you have, you can add Twitter, you can add Todoist, you can add the stocks, you can actually add Now Playing, which I do like because it can help you with quick access to the music that you're playing if you're using Apple Music. I'm going to take that one out of this one now. So you can add a few others, and you can go to the App Store and find other ones that you may want, like flight information and so on and so forth. So the sidebar and the spotlight, when you use these are built into your Mac, and they are so useful, and they can really speed up the work that you're doing and give you essential information when you need it. It's just one of those little extra things that you'll find incredibly useful, and it really does help you to boost your productivity when you're working on a Mac all day. So hopefully that's just giving you a few ideas. What I would recommend is that you actually go and play with these and see what you can do. And then really it's about developing the muscle memory. So as I say, for me, I have my own particular keyboard shortcuts for these. Normally to get Spotlight, it's Command Spacebar. For me, Command Spacebar actually controls the language input because I often write in Korean. But for you, you may not need to change that. So I have a different keyboard shortcut, but these are so useful. And the sidebar you just get to, either you can just swipe in from the right, or if you want, if you go to the top line, you can just hit this button here, and it will bring it out here. This is your sidebar, if you like, right there. Okay, so thank you very much for watching this video. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you have enjoyed these Apple videos that I'm doing, and you want to build your very own Apple productivity system, then please check out my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course, which is available from my learning center and is incredible value. And it will show you how to bring all these parts together, the Notes app, iCloud, reminders, and calendar into one beautiful productivity system. Check out the course here. The details are below, and I hope to see you in the course.